Hello everyone, myself Neha Shah from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. Today I am explaining more example based on probability mass function from the unit of basic probability from the subject of probability and statistics. Up to last session, I had explained you random variable, what is probability mass function, and in the last session, I had explained you some examples based on probability mass function. Now today, I will explain more examples based on this probability mass function. In the last session, I had explained you 5 examples based on probability mass function. So the 6th example is a random variable X has the following probability distribution. For this particular example, probability distribution is given to you. Like X equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. For that, the value of probability is also given to you. P of X equals to X. Means probability of X equals to X is equals to A, 4A, 3A, 7A, 8A, 10A, 6A and 9A. It means if you are representing any random variable X along with its probability, then this kind of distribution is considered as probability distribution. In this particular example, the probability distribution is given to you. From that, you have to find out something. Like, you have to find the value of A. Here the constant A is given to you. So first of all, you have to find out the value of A. Then you have to find out probability of X is less than 3. And then you have to find out the smallest value of M for which the probability of X is less than or equals to M and its value is greater than or equals to 0.6. Means in the third term, we have to find out the value of M for which this condition will satisfy. So starting with the first term, first of all, if we want to find out the value of A, how are we finding the value of A? So for this, you have given that this one is the probability distribution. And when we'll apply the probability distribution? Only if we're considering that this function is probability mass function. And if it will be probability mass function, so the first condition is the value of all the probabilities will be greater than 0. It means the value of probability will be positive. The second condition is the value of summation of all the probability should be equals to 1. So if we are taking this condition, then we can find out the value of A. So if you want to solve the example, so starting with this condition, first of all, if we are taking summation probability of X equals to 1. So summation of all the probabilities as A plus 4A plus 3A plus 7A plus 8A plus 10A plus 6A plus 9A. So this term should be equals to 1. Now if I'm simplifying this, the total of this equals to 48A. So 48A equals to 1. So from that, if I'm finding the value of A, so the value of A equals to 1 upon 48. Now, the second term we have to find out the value of probability of X is less than 3. Less than 3 means we will not including the term 3. So, before 3, which terms will be there? X equals to 0, X equals to 1 and X equals to 2. So, if I am taking the summation of all the probability, then it will give you the term as probability of X less than 3. Here we are taking the summation of all the probabilities directly. Why? Because there is not a common part in between X equals to 0, X equals to 1, X equals to, right? So we are taking the summation of all this term. So if I am finding the value of probability of X is less than 3, so its value will be probability of X equals to 0 plus probability of X equals to 1 plus probability of X equals to 2. Now we will not taking the value of probability of X equals to 3 because you had given the value of probability of X is less than 3. Now suppose the same example if I am giving you as probability of X is less than or equals to 3, then we have to include 3 also, because we have considered less than or equals to. So we have to include the term x equals to 3. Now here the term is given as probability of x is less than 3, so we will take it up to only 2. Now if I am finding the probability of this 3 terms, so what are the probabilities? The probability of x equals to 0 is equals to a, probability of x equals to 1 is 4a, and probability of x equals to 2 equals to 3a. So from this we can take a plus 4a plus 3a. So a plus 4a means 5a plus 3a means 8a. So the value of total probability up to this equals to 8 into a. Now if we are putting the value of a, so value of a equals to 1 upon 48. So the term will be 8 into 1 upon 48. Now 8, 8 will be cancelled out. So this term will consider as 1 by 6. So the value of probability of x less than 3 equals to 1 by 6. Now the third term you have to find out the value of smallest value of n for which this condition will satisfy. So if we are taking probability of x is less than or equals to 2, so its value will be 1 upon 6. So its value will be 0.16666, right? So it is too much less compared to 0.6. But we have to take the value of this probability should be greater than 0.6. So we are increasing this. So likewise we are taking probability of x is less than or equals to 3, probability of x is less than or equals to 4, probability of x is less than or equals to 5. Likewise we are calculating the probability. And from that we have to find out which probability is greater than 0.6. Like we are taking the value of n equals to 4, because if I am taking n equals to 2, so it is far less compared to 0.6. So we will also consider that for n equals to 3 also it will be less than 0.6. So I am considering that the value of n equals to 4. So if I am taking n equals to 4, then the value of probability of x is less than or equals to 4. So its value will be a plus 4a plus 3a plus 7a plus 8a, because we have considered probability of x equals to 0, probability of x equals to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here we will include the probability of x equals to 4, because we have to find out probability of x is less than or equals to 4. So if I am finding the summation of all this term, so the term will be a plus 4a means 5a plus 3a means 8a plus 7a means 15a plus 8a means 23a. Now if we are putting the value of a, the value of a equals to 1 upon 48, so the term will be 23 into 1 divided by 48. So its value will be 0.479, which is not greater than or equals to 0.6. It means it is not satisfying this condition. So we can say that we can't take value of n equals to 4. So n is not possible. Now if we are taking n equals to 5, so what will be the term? This one is for n equals to 4, right? In this, if I am adding the value of probability of x equals to 5, so it will give you the term as probability of x is less than or equals to 5. So the term will be, this term will be 23a plus probability of x equals to 5, its value will be 10a. So if I am finding total of this, so its value will be 33 into a. Now if I am putting the value of a equals to 1 upon 48, so the term will be 33 into 1 upon 48. Now if I am finding the value of this, then its value will be 0.6875. So it will satisfy the condition this is greater than or equals to 0.6. So the smallest value of n will be 5. So this way we can find out the value of any constant which will satisfy some conditions. Now the next example is the probability mass function of a random variable x is 0 except at points x equals to 0, 1 and 2. Means The probability mass function for any random variable x is given for a particular range like 0, 1 and 2. At this point, it has the value probability of x equals to 0, its value will be 3c cubed. Probability of x equals to 1, its value will be 4c minus 10c square. Probability of x equals to 2, its equation is 5c minus 1. Find the value of constant c. Then you have to find out probability of x less than 1. Then you have to find out probability of x in between 1 to 2. In this, we will not including 1, but we will including the term 2. Then you have to find out probability of x in between 0 to 2. In this also we will including 2, but we will not including 0 term. Okay. So if we want to solve this example, so starting with the term probability mass function, it means for this particular example, you have given that this one is the probability mass function. So we are taking the condition of it, and from that we will finding the value of the constant. After finding the value of constant, we will finding this particular probabilities. So what are the condition of probability mass function? As you know that the probability mass function's condition are, the first one is the value of probability should be greater than 0. It means the value of probability should be positive. The second term is the summation of all the probability should be equals to 1 because it is certain event, right? So we have to take these two conditions, and from that we have to find out the value of constant c. So starting with it, when taking probability of x equals to x, it is considered as probability mass function. So when taking the condition as summation of probability of x equals to x, its value equals to 1. In this, we will taking probability of x equals to 0, 1 and 2, because you have given the value of x equals to 0, 1 and 2, right? So we are taking probability of x equals to 0 plus probability of x equals to 1 plus probability of x equals to 2. And the answer of this equals to 1. Now, if we will put in the values of this, what is the probability of x equals to 0? Its value will be 3c cubed. Similarly, probability of x equals to 1, its value will be 4c minus 10c square, and the value of probability of x equals to 2 is equals to 5c minus 1. So we are putting these three values in this equation is equals to 1. Now if I am simplifying this, then what will be the next step? 3c cube minus 10c square plus 9c minus 1. And this one also goes over here. So this term will be minus 2 is equals to 0. And if we are solving this function, so it will give you three different factors, because the highest degree of this function is 3. So it will give you the three different factors, right? So the first factor is 3c minus 1, the second factor is c minus 2, and the third factor is c minus 1 is equals to 0. So from this, if I am finding the value of c, then the term will be c equals to 1, c equals to 2, and c equals to 1 by 3. So from the values of c equals to 1, 2 and 1 by 3, we have to find out which one is the correct one. So we'll starting with the value of c equals to 1. Suppose if I am taking c equals to 1 and if I am putting the value of c in this term, so what is the value of probability of x equals to 0? Its value will be 3 into 1 cube, right? 1 cube equals to 1 and 1 into 3. So the answer of it equals to 3. So from this we can say that probability of x equals to 0, its value equals to 3. And as you know that the value of probability should be in the range of 0 to 1. So from this we can say that the value of probability of x equals to 0 equals to 3. It is not possible, so we can't take the value of c equals to 1. Now similarly, if we are taking c equals to 2, so what will be the term? 2 cube means 8, 8 into 3 means 24. So this also not possible, because the probability of x equals to 0 equals to 24, and we can't take the value of any probability greater than 1. So we can't take c equals to 2. So the final value of c equals to 1 by 3. So First term, we have find the value of constant C equals to 1 by 3. Now we have to find out the value of probability of X is less than 1. So if I am taking probability of X less than 1 means we have to find out the value of probability of X equals to 0. Now if I am taking probability of X equals to 0, what is the equation? Probability of X equals to 0 means 3C cube. Now if I am taking 3C cube, in this if I am taking C equals to 1 by 3, so 1 by 3 is cube. 3 will be cancelled out. So the final term is probability of X equals to 0 is equals to 1 upon 3 square means 1 upon 9. Now the next term you have to find out probability of X in between 1 to 2. In this we will including 2 but will not including 1. So we have to find out the value of probability of X equals to 2 only. Right? So if I am finding probability of X equals to 2, what is the equation? Probability of X equals to 2 equals to 5C minus 1. Now in this term, if we put in the value of C equals to 1 by 3, so the term will be 5 by 3 minus 1. And if I am simplifying 5 by 3 minus 1, 3 goes over there, so 5 minus 3 by 3. So 5 minus 3 means 2 by 3. So the final value of probability of X equals to 2 equals to 2 by 3. Now, if I am finding the value of probability of X in between 0 to 2, so the term will be probability of X equals to 1 plus probability of X equals to 2. Because we will not including 0 and less than or equals to 2, it means we will including the value of X equals to 2. So, if I am finding the value of probability of X equals to 1, so its value will be 2 by 9. And if I am finding probability of X equals to 2, so its value will be 2 by 3. So if I am simplifying this, 3 goes over here. So 3 into 2, 6 plus 2, 8 divided by 9. So the final value of this probability is equals to 8 by 9. Now if I am representing this in the form of probability mass function, it means distribution of X and probability of X. So we can write down like this, X equals to X, the value of X equals to 0, 1 and 2, and when finding the probability of X equals to X, for value of X equals to 0, its probability equals to 1 by 9. Now if I am finding probability of X equals to 1, as you know that its probability equals to 2 by 9 and the probability of X equals to 2, its value will be 2 by 3. So if we are representing the term X and probability of X in this tabular form, so it will consider as probability mass function representation. Now the next example is from a lot of 10 items containing 3 defectives. A sample of 4 items is drawn at a random. Let the random variable X denote the number of defective items in the sample space. Find the probability distribution function of X. If we are solving this example, then we will say that the total number of items equals to 10, the number of defectives equals to 3. So number of good items equals to total minus defective means 10 minus 3 equals to 7. Now if I am defining the random variable X which will denote the number of defective items, so maximum defective items are 3. So, we are taking that not a single defective item means X equals to 0, one defective item means X equals to 1, likewise the maximum defective items will be 3. So, we are taking the random variable X as 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now, from this we have to find out the probability distribution function of X. As you know that we are representing the probability distribution function in the table form as X along with its probability. So for different values of X, we have to find out the probability of that particular value of X. And if we are representing it in this tabular form, so it will be representing as the probability distribution function. So starting with X equals to 0, if we are finding the value of probability of X equals to 0, it means not a single defective item. So no defective item. So, if we are finding probability of X equals to 0 means probability of not a single defective item, then its value equals to, from total 10 items, we have to select 4 items, right? So from 10 items we have to select 4. So we are taking the combination of 10C4. From that we have to select not a single defective item. So all items are good items. So we are taking 7. From that we have to select any 4. So we are taking 7C4. Now if I am simplifying 7C4 divided by 10C4, so its answer will be 1/6. Now the next term we have to find for x equals to 1. It means we have to take one defective item. It means we are taking one defective item and 3 good items. So how we are calculating the probability of that? So for that we are taking from total 10 items we have to select 4 items. But from 3 defective items we have to select 1 defective item. And from 7 good items we have to select 3 good items. So the term will be 3C1 into 7C3 divided by 10C4. If I am solving this term, so it will give you the answer as 1/2. If I am finding the value of x equals to 2's probability, means probability of x equals to 2. It means the probability of 2 defective items and 2 good items, because we have to select 4 items, right? So from 3 defective items we have to select 2 items, so it will be considered as 3C2, and from 7 good items we have to select 2 good items, so it will consider as 7C2. From the total number is from total 10 items we have to select 4 items, so we will write in 10C4. Now if I am simplifying this, then its answer will be 3/10. Similarly, if I am finding the value of probability of x equals to 3, so what will be the term? Probability of 3 defective items and 1 good item, because we have to select 4 items, right? So from 3 defective items we are selecting 3 defective items, and from 7 good items we are selecting 1 good item. So the term will be 3C3 7C1 divided by total items will be 10. From that we have to select 4 items. So the term will be 10C4. Now if I am simplifying this term, so answer of it equals to 1/30. Now if we are taking the value of x equals to 4, is it possible? No, because we have to select 4 items, but maximum defective items will be 3. So we can't take the value of x equals to 4. So up to 3 only we have to find its probability. Now I am representing the random variable x along with its probability in the tabular form, so it will consider as probability distribution function. So the term will be x equals to x, its value will be 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now the probability of x equals to x, its value will be, for x equals to 0 its value will be 1/6, probability of x equals to 1 its value will be 1/2. Then the next term is probability of x equals to 2, its value is 3/10, and the probability of x equals to 3, its value will be 1/3. So if we are putting all this value over here, so we can represent it in the form of probability distribution function. So this way we can solve the examples of probability mass function. Thank you so much.